at the age of 2, I was diagnosed with a form of autism called Asperger syndrome, which really impacted on my life and my education. The way it affects me is emotionally. I would cry multiple times a day, every day, my entire life. I would always avoid people because I was really incredibly shy. I wouldn't even ask questions about my work or put my hand up in class, which meant that I would sometimes lag behind. It wasn't so much them judging me that bothered me, it was the fact that everyone was judging my mum. Like how this one person saw me have one of my tantrums that I used to have and saying, I know what I'd like to do with her. There was this, my sister's college had this lecture about autism awareness, and there was this woman who came in to talk about it, and she was saying these things like, do not approach them as they are dangerous and they will harm you. Only one person stood up in that entire lecture hall, my sister. And she said, that's bloody wrong. That's just wrong. My sister is the sweetest person you'll ever meet. She would never hurt anyone. The worst part is all the teachers and the students were telling my sister to sit down and keep her mouth shut. This one time, I was looking on the internet about cures for it, and when it said that there is no cure, I broke down right there and then. In a way, I was happy that I found out, because it brought me into light of why I always felt so different and why I was always treated so differently. But it also brought me into a harsh reality about myself. Like feeling that, like realizing how it affected me as a child and how it would continue to affect me for the rest of my life. I guess you could say that I break the stigma a little bit. Like when people meet me and I tell them that I have Asperger syndrome, they say, you don't look autistic. And I know they don't mean that as a mean thing. I guess like they mean it's like, oh, I've had this preconception of autism and you've just broken it. When I came to the University of Sunderland, things started to change for me. Like during my first year, I would still have my breakdowns, but they were less frequent. When I was applying for university, I met with the disability support team, and they were really helpful in explaining the type of support that I would get here. But generally, my first few days here were actually all right. I had a member of staff with me. I learned to talk to people, like I would start off conversations first, which before I would never be able to do. So I would definitely say that coming here to the University of Sunderland has definitely brought me out of my shell. I studied health and social care in college with the ambition to become a counsellor or work with people with autism myself. I still hope, like with my health and social care course now at the university, I will hope to work with people like me and help them find their way. My Nana passed away a few years ago. She would never let me feel alone, even for one second. And I like to bring that into my everyday life. Like, I never like to make anyone feel alone either. Like, for example, if everyone's having a conversation and there's someone who feels like they're not being joined in, I'll say, oh, what do you think? Whenever I make a new friend, I tell them of what I have so that if ever I do have a breakdown, they know why, so as not to make them feel uncomfortable. All my friends are really accepting of it and they treat me like any other individual, which I really love. Like, I love being treated like any other person, like after so many years of being treated like I'm lower than everyone else. It's the best feeling in the world, if you ask me.